Wow. Yes. All right. We have a new number here. For Canada, we have 867-292-3030 for Canada. I will type it. And then in US, for USA, for US, we have 712-832-8330. So these are the new numbers, and the code number is the same. So once, if you are USA, you just call 712-832-8330. If you are in USA, and if you are in Canada, this is the number you call for Canada. 867-292-3030. If you are in Canada, we have changed the number so that we can accommodate everybody. People of USA, they cannot call this number. But if you are in USA, this is the number 712-832-8330. And if you are in Canada, you can call this number 867-292-3030. These are the numbers for our new conference, prayer conference. So that's what I was working, but I found it is working now fine. We have been given five different countries. So by tomorrow, I will know all the countries, how it works. So people from UK, they have their number. They can call it to the conference, and they don't have to pay long distance. That is how this number is working, which means that everyone will be accommodated. I have five countries that I was given the number. So it's amazing. It's a miracle. Now, everybody will be accommodated. We thank God for that. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes. I want to thank God for everything. That our God is a mighty God and this wonderful God. I don't know how many people are there. You give me hearts. Hallelujah. I want to see their hearts. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you. Yes. Give me more hearts. Thank you, friends. Yeah. Yes, I know you were writing the number, but the number is on online. USA is the one that I didn't put online, but I'm going to put it correct because I didn't know how it works. Now I found that it is working. Thank you, Anne Kay. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Glory be the name of Jesus. Recording, I don't know how to do it, but by tomorrow I will run and know how to do it. I'm going to try again and see how it works. But if I don't record, that's not a problem. The video will be on YouTube. Hello? Yes, hello.
Hi.
Hi. Can you hear me clearly? Your name? Good, good, good. Yes, that's fine. Welcome, welcome. So I'm trying to accommodate everybody. This is amazing. Canadian, they have their number. UK, they have their number. And Canada, they have their number. So everyone is going to be accommodated. Oh, wow, this is wonderful. But I thank God for everything. Welcome. Yes, tonight I have so much things and I'm excited. Yeah, God is good. When I was praying, I saw a vision. And this vision is a very serious vision. I tried to share during the day. It was 1 o'clock, scope, that I went to the periscope and I do a short scope to explain what I saw. So God is good. When I was praying, this is what I saw. I saw the bullets, so many bullets. They are ready to go. to destroy the enemies. So when I look at that, I scared. I thought they are coming to destroy destroy me. But they were looking the south, and all of them, they were ready to go. Now the Lord was telling me that these bullets, they are the ones that I'm ready to risk to the enemies. So there is going to be a slaughter, a destroying. It is going to be the kingdom of God, the kingdom of the devil. God is going to destroy them. It is going really to destroy. God is very angry for what is going on in the world. So God has released bullets upon bullets to go to the camp of the enemy and destroy them. So therefore, people of God, I want everybody to be humble themselves and pray and repent so that you don't have to get any bullet from God, because God is really angry. God is a machine gun killer, and he can kill people. God is very angry. He has angels that he can assign. That's why the title, we pray that deliverance prayer to request for angelic assistance from God. So we need a prayer that we request angel from God to come and assist us. We can't fight by ourselves. We need angels of God. I want to read from you the book of 2 Kings 19, verse 32 to 35. Let's pray. Our Father, in the name of Jesus, you are our God and you are our Father. We thank you because of your divine protection. We thank you that God, you are God, and what you say yes is yes, and what you say you mean it is yes and yes. You don't change God. You are not a man to lie. God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for your word. We thank you, God, that you are able, my Father, to change circumstances, to change a difficult situation, to change the circumstances around us to favor us, God. My God, I want to thank you for you are so good, you are so kind, that God, you can release your angels to come and assist us tonight. It is a night that God, you are going to release angels, your angels, to assist us, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. I want to thank you, God. I thank you, my God, every work of the enemy, every activities and assignment of the enemy that has been issued, assigned to come and destroy us, or to come and infect us, or to come and destroy us. Father God, according to your word, God, you are God who protect us. Lord, I pray that God release your divine protection. Protect us, God, my Father. Release your angels of protection, God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Lord, I want to thank you. I thank you and I give all the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki. Welcome you. Welcome newcomers. I welcome you in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining. This is a deliverance and healing ministry. It's based on spiritual warfare. So our prayers are not very nice. Maybe you may think that why is these people are praying very, very, very dangerous prayer like that? Why do they can pray like that? That is how we do spiritual warfare. We have to tell the devil off. Otherwise, if you cannot be aggressive, the devil cannot help you. The devil can destroy you. And the devil is not your friend. That's why we need to go with a very aggressive prayer. The Bible says the kingdom of heaven suffer, the kingdom of God suffer defiant, and defiant would take by force. So if you are not defiant, you can't take it. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord, thank you, Father. We thank you, God. We honor you, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. If I broke you by mistake, call me back. Sometimes I broke somebody by mistake, and sometimes the computer itself broke evil people. So I don't know how it works, but I found some other people have been broke. So I don't know if it is me or it's the other person. I have no idea. So in case, if you are one of us and I broke you, don't worry. I didn't broke you intentionally. I'm broken the enemies. Therefore, you can call me through the number, my phone number, and then I can unblock you. Thank you very much. So I'm going to read from the book of 2 Kings, 19, verse 32 to 35. The Bible says, hallelujah, thank you, thank you. God bless you. Thank you, my dear. Thank you so much. The Bible says, therefore, thus says the Lord, concerning the king of Syria, he shall not come in this city, or shoot an arrow there, or come before it with a shield or a cast up a siege molded against it. By the way that he came, by the same he shall return, and he shall not come in this city, declares the Lord. For I will defend this city to save it for my own sake and for the sake of my servant David. So, the God himself, God Almighty, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, has swear, has vowed, has said that this enemy will not come to this city. The enemy that is assigned to come to you, he will not come. God has refused. God has said the enemy, he will not come to you. God is talking. He will not come to this city. He will not come to your city. The enemy that plans to come and bring a siege, to come and bring evil, he will not be assigned to come to your city. The terrorist, the wicked, the evil, the witchcraft, evil people are not assigned to come to your city. God is against them. God is against those wicked people. So God himself said, therefore, thus says the Lord, concerning the kings of Syria, he shall not come unto this city, or shoot an arrow there, or come before it with a shield or a cast up a siege molded against it. By the way that he came, by the same he shall return, and he shall not come unto this city, declares the Lord. For I will defend this city, save it for my own sake and for the sake of my servant David. And that night the angel of the Lord went out and struck down 185,000 in the camp of Syrians. And when people arose early in the morning, behold, they were all dead carcass. That this was a great enemy who brought a siege in the city of Samaria. A siege, he brought famine, he brought disaster, famine. This king, he made the people, the children of Israel suffer. He made he caused disaster in that city. So the Lord said, now it is the time that this man will never enter in this city. He will never come in this city. This man was the one who was exalting himself. He was disrespecting the children of Israel. He said that he's going to whip them, he's going to destroy them. He was saying that King Jehoshaphat was lying to the children of Israel. Any enemies that is disrespecting you, they see like you have no God. Today, tonight, the Lord is going to strike them down and all of them will die in the name of Jesus. What you have been going through, all these attacks you have been getting all the time, the Lord Almighty will assign the angels. Angels of God is going to shoot every enemy that has been assigned against you to destroy completely in the name of Jesus. Look at what he did to these Assyrians. One angel, just one angel. It is not angels, just one angel. Went there and slaughtered those people, all of them. There's God. When you ask the angel and assistance angel, when you ask God assistance for angelic angel, God is not a respecter of a person. That's why David was winning all the time. Now, when the enemy is saying that it's coming to destroy you, don't worry. Just request angelic of God, angelic assistance from God. God for sure, He would never forsake you or leave you. He would assign one angel. That's why his word says, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. When God, one angel killed 185,000, what if the angels would go? What if there were 10 angels there? That they would be nothing. So I'm telling you that when you are in need, when you are surrounded by the enemy, when you are being attacked by witchcraft, when your situation is so difficult, I request the angelica from God. I request the angel, because everyone has been given angels to guide them. Give your angels work. That's why we ask angels. That's why David was praying, let the angels of God chase my enemies. When David understood how to use the angels. That is what the Bible says. The Bible says, let's look on the scripture. When David was using the angels, he asked, let the angels of God, hallelujah, let the angels of God chase them. Chase your enemies. We use the angels of God to destroy your enemies and kill them. I saw that these things that I saw, it was terrifying. I saw how the bullet, really the bullet that is going to attack, going to shoot the enemy. When the enemy is planning that he's coming to shoot you, the Lord Almighty will shoot him and he will never come back. That's what the Bible says. Let's look at the book of Psalms 35. This is what I love so much. I love Psalms 35 because David is a man of God. And David never lose any battle. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. These things has provoked the enemies. The enemy are manifested like something else. It is disturbing witches and wizards because their time is up. I'm telling you, many people, if they are not going to repent, the wrath of God is going to fall upon them, and God himself is going to destroy them. Not Satan. This is the hand of God, because God is very angry with the wicked every day. God has given them chance to repent, and they don't want to repent. They want to do wicked every day. Their time is up. They will not return back. The Bible says the way they come is the way they will return back. So God Almighty is against wicked every day. This is him. This is God says. He says, therefore, thus says the Lord concerning the king of Syria, he shall not come in this city in the name of Jesus. Let's look on the book of Psalms 35. Yes, thank you, Jesus. My God, I want to thank you, Father. You are so good, God. You are great God, my Father. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. My God. Let's look at the book of Psalms 35 from verse 5. Psalms 35, verse 5, the Bible says, let them be as craft, as chaff before the wind, and let the angel of the Lord chase them. Let the angel, just not two angels, just angel. He said, let the angel of God chase them. David asked God, said, let the angel of God chase them. Let the angels of God chase your enemies. Every enemy that is following you, every enemy, anything that is working against you, they are following you. Wherever you go, they are there. Wherever you start anything, they are there. When you start this business, they are there to destroy it. They will say, start, put your money there, and then they will come and take that money. You lose everything. You close down your business because of the wicked. The angel of God will chase them. This time we are going to use the angels of God. Tonight, the Bible says at night, not today, God released the angels. It says, the Bible says, verse 35, in the book of 2 Kings 19, verse 35, the Bible says, and that night, the angel of the Lord went out and struck down 185,000 in the camp of the Syrians. And when people arose early in the morning, behold, these were all dead bodies. So they were killed. And that king who was saying that he's coming to destroy the children of Israel, He went to his country and his own children killed him. So your enemy will kill himself in Jesus' name. Your enemy will be destroyed themselves in the name of Jesus. Every enemy that is working against you, every power that is working against you, they will destroy themselves in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray that the angels of God will chase your enemies in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I commit your people into your hand. I command every power that is working against them, the angels of God will destroy them. The angel of God will strike them and destroy them in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will come and destroy the works of the enemy that is working against you in Jesus' name. I want to thank God so much that God is a mighty God. Our God takes care of us. He cannot leave us or forsake us. As the Bible says, that God Almighty is God who does not lie. It's not a man that will lie. God is very angry. The Bible says he's angry with the enemy, with the wicked every day. He gives them chance to repent because our God is so good. He loves us. He gives everybody chance to repent and turn away from his wicked and turn away from his evil. And still people, they don't want to listen to God. They want to do so wicked. They have sold their soul to the devil. So therefore, God is against them. If you see what is happening, people, what they do, you can just say, let God, let Jesus come even today, just as we talk right now. And many, many will go to hellfire because the people, they decided to do wicked and good. Now God is against them. The Bible says the judgment of God will start from the house of God. The world people, they belong to the devil, so they have no problem. The church, the pastors, the bishop, the prophetess, people of God, you see the church of God, they are full of witchcraft. You go to the church and you find thieves, criminals in the church. The wrath of God is coming to the church. And it's going to show, God is going to prove that it's God. Therefore, this is a big warning. And I want you to, I'm asking you by the grace of God to change and live the right way that God wants you to live. There is heaven. There is no way, there is no doubt that you can say there is no heaven and there is no hell. There is hell and there is heaven. People have gone there. People have gone to hell and see how hell looks like. People have gone to heaven and see how heaven looks like. Therefore, if you don't want to go to hellfire, just change yourself. Here is a king who did not respect God. He doesn't care about the people of God. The same thing that people of God, they don't care. You are in the church, but you are so angry. You are greedy. You are jealousy. You are envy. You are full of envy. You don't want other people. You don't want to see anybody with anything. If you see a new convert coming to your church, you think he's coming to take over your position. So those people, God is watching you. Your time is up. If you cannot change, look at that. The angel of God has been released and is going to work on the wicked very bad. People who are living in a greedy, people living in a very, 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 very greedy people, angry, jealousy, and you are calling yourself a Christian. That's why you need to die to self. You need to die to self. You need to ask the flesh to die so that you don't go to hellfire. This wicked king, he thought that he's going to destroy the children of Israel. And the people of Syria, they said they are going to attack these people and bring them ashes. They were very proud, arrogant, because they know that God is not there. You might be the enemy that is working against you. He might disrespect you, despise you, rejecting you, thinking that you have no God. But God is dressing up. God is going to attack them big that they cannot be able to go. I pray that God will deliver you tonight. Every enemy that is working against you, may the angels of God chase them. May the angels of God salute them. In the name of Jesus. May the angels of God attack them and destroy them in the name of Jesus. Let them meet the angels of God. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. Enough is enough. You've been suffering so much. You have been going through difficult time. Now I pray that let God release his angels to attack the enemies that is affecting you in the name of Jesus Christ. This is what is it happened, and it will happen. Don't think that this was Old Testament. You have seen the disaster coming upon disaster, natural disaster. That's God strike the cities and make that place to be pieces. That's what is happening. If God said Sodom and Gomorrah fire, and all those people were burned to ashes, yeah? If God can use the flood, when he was talking to Noah, say, Noah, I'm going to destroy this earth. I'm going to destroy everybody. Tell them to come. I'm building the ark. Tell them to come. Noah started preaching and telling the people, repent, repent. God is going to destroy. The people were saying, you are out of your mind. So when the flood came, it rained 40 days? Yes, nonstop, day and night. And then the people, they see, this person was right. Now they tried to run, but the door was closed. I pray that the door will not be closed for you in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will deliver you. God will deliver you and have mercy. You have a chance to repent and turn back to God before God can release his angels to come and slew and stain and kill every wicked people. This is not New Testament only. This is not Old Testament only. People think that this was Old Testament. These things happen even right now. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, I want to thank you that God, tonight you will talk to your people and your people will return and come to you, God, my Father. I pray that God Almighty deliver your people. Deliver your people, God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. God, you are able, Father. We love you, Jesus. We worship you, God. We thank you, my God, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I worship you, my God. We know that God, you are our Father. You are full of mercy. You love us so much. But you are against the wicked. You are against evil. You are against witchcraft. You are against criminals, God. You are so good. You are so good. But you are against wicked people. Yes, Lord, I want to thank you, God. That God, you the people, they are yours. The devil does not create anybody. Devil Satan does not create anybody. Everybody, the people, they are yours, God. But when they refuse to obey you, when they turn themselves to be God, God, you get angry with them. And Lord, I pray for your mercy, God, my Father. My God, help us. Help us, Lord, God. The guns, the bullet that I saw, God. My Father, my God, I pray that God, help us. Help us and forgive us. Forgive us, God, my Father. In the name of Jesus. I want to thank God that God would deliver you and protect you. You will not be one of the wicked people. You will not be one of the victims. If you know you are a wicked, turn. Because the wrath of God is already been out. I'm telling you, you will see soon what is going to happen. People, the wicked people, they are going to face very difficult life. You children of God, you will be loving and you will not be affected. You will not be affected. The disaster is coming big and nobody will control it. Even the scientific people, educated people with wisdom, they will not be able to control it because that is the wrath of God himself. If he comes and sent one angel to kill 185,000, what about when he sent 10 angels? Lord, God is not a man to play games. He's God and we love him because he's God. Don't worry about those wicked witchcraft who are doing evil to you because they are finished. God is going to destroy them, all of them, and you will be rejoiced. You've been suffering enough. So enough is enough. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for you. Thank you for coming. I have to stop here. God bless you so much. We'll continue tomorrow. I'm going to talk the very strong topic tomorrow of warning. So it is like when you are surrounded by the enemy, what to do? That is the topic. I declared before, but that is the continuation of the topic that I had. Yesterday I was talking about when you are surrounded by witchcraft, what to do. So we would ask assistance of angelic assistance from God. God would help us and he would assist us in the name of Jesus. Thank you very much. This is your host, Prophetess Dr. Christine Isiki, saying bye-bye to you. We have changed our prayer line number. For USA, your number is 712-832-8330. And for Canada, your number is 86-729-23020. So if you people, not everybody who comes to Periscope, not everybody who has computer, or they don't know how to go to Periscope, but the number, it is, you can give them the number. Share with your friends. Share this number. Give to them. Yes, you share this number, it will help them. So go to our website. There's videos, there's materials there which can help you. www.overcomersdhministry.blogspot.ca. Or you can send me email. If you need prayers, I'm here to help you, to assist you. And then we can request the angels of God to come and help you. You need angels of God. I was praying with a woman in Australia. And I saw the angels were assigned to come and help her. But the woman, I told her, be careful. The angels of God has been raised to you. So you be careful. Don't provoke them. And then this woman was thinking that I was just praying, or I was not serious. And I saw the angels was assigned to her. So angels, for sure, everyone has about 6,000 angels to guide you. So take care. Ask God assistance for angels to help you. Thank you very much. God bless you. See you tomorrow, midnight, the same time. Have a wonderful time. Thank you very much. Talk to you. If you need prayers, call me. Our numbers, you know them. And we'll see. Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Bye.